Hello everyone, welcome back to another Affinity Designer tutorial. I am your host, Elias Sarantopoulos. The Node tool inside Affinity Designer is used to edit existing curves and shapes with different modes, actions, transformations, and snapping controls. So I will cover all these topics and get you ready to edit your artwork. So inside Affinity Designer, we will start this off talking about how to select nodes. Here, I have created just a simple straight segment. So I will activate the Node tool and tap one node at a time in order to make a selection. Now to select multiple nodes, you can either marquee select more than one node or select one node, add a one-finger modifier on the canvas, and tap to select more nodes. You can move a node by selecting it and moving it around, or inside the Transform Studio, you can interactively change the X and Y coordinates of that node. You can also add a one-finger modifier on the canvas and constrain the movement to 45-degree increments like so. Now, a four-finger modifier will initially create a cusp point with two independent control handles. But if we align those two together using the Node tool, then we get a smooth point. Adding a node is as simple as tapping once on one of the straight segments or tap again to add more. We can also tap on the delete icon to remove one node or more. When we select the Node tool, the context toolbar appears, presenting us with a group of node conversion types, the sharp, the smooth, and the smart node type. Here we have a triangle made of straight segments and sharp nodes, which is the first node type. The second node type is the smooth node, so tap on it, and that will convert a node to a smooth node, creating a smooth point with these two linked control handles. In this case, we can reposition the node itself or adjust the control handles. When we add a one-finger modifier while dragging the node, that will constrain the movement to 45-degree increments. But when we add a one-finger modifier while dragging one of the control handles, that will create a cusp point, which allows us to move one handle independently from the other. A four-finger modifier on the canvas will change the node type to a sharp node, and again create a cusp point. Similar to the smooth node, with a smart node, Affinity Designer decides how smooth your curves should be. It determines the shape of the curves required between the nodes, represented by a circle with a dot inside. Now let us talk about the actions available to manipulate curves, which includes the break, the close, the smooth, the join, and the reverse action. Here we have a closed curve with no endpoints. So I will select this node, and then I will tap on the break node action, which removes the curve because it is separating the endpoints. The nodes will be split into two different anchor points, one for this line and one for the other line. And if you want to connect those anchor points back again, just drag one node right on top of the other. Here I will demonstrate the join and close actions. So in this example, we have two separate curves. Inside the Layer Studio, I will select both paths, marquee select the tap nodes with the Node tool, and use the join curve action, which connects two separate curves together to make one curve. Then I will close the curve by tapping on the close curve action, which joins the start and end nodes to create an enclosed shape. Here's another example of joining and closing curves, this time around with two straight segments. Notice the proximity between those two. In this case, Affinity Designer will join those first, regardless which nodes we select. Now just tap on the close action and close the path. The reverse occurs when we change the position of the line and bring it closer to the other end. The nodes closer in proximity will be joined first. The reverse curves action reverses the direction the curve was drawn in. So in this case, we have a curved open path with two endpoints and an arrowhead on one of the ends. So when we tap on the reverse curves action, we can see the start anchor point becoming the endpoint. The smooth curve action modifies a line or shape by adding and removing nodes to create a rounder and softer curve effect. In this case, we have an open path with three nodes, so I will marquee select all the nodes and tap on the smooth curve, which gives us smooth nodes with control handles. All we have to do now is to follow the shape of the hard contour by dragging those around. Snapping nodes is independent of global snapping, and the snapping controls Affinity Designer offers can be very useful and effective. So let us go ahead and see how these controls work. The Align to Nodes of selected curves aligns any moving node you drag to any other node on the same or different curve. So first, I will select those two vertical lines by adding a one-figure modifier on the canvas. And I will horizontally line up the nodes. The horizontal red line indicates horizontal snapping. I will do the same for the horizontal segments, and I will vertically line up the nodes. The vertical green line indicates vertical snapping. Very powerful. The snapped geometry of selected curves will snap moving node to the same or different curve's path or node. In other words, we can drag this node and align it to the geometry of the same curve, indicated by the yellow snapping indicator. We can also snap the same node or bunch of nodes to a different curve. So in this case, inside the Layer Studio, I will select both curves and then drag those nodes to the geometry of the other curve. Again, indicated by the yellow snapping indicator. In conjunction with the Align to Nodes of selected curve, the Snap All Selected Nodes when dragging will snap multiple selected nodes when dragging to a target node on any selected curves. In this case, I will marquee select a bunch of nodes and reposition them. The horizontal red line and vertical green line indicates the nodes are in alignment. In conjunction with the snap to geometry of selected curves, the align handle positions using snapping options will align control handles to the geometry and nodes of the same curve and be able to follow the path. In this example, I would drag this control handle, align it to the geometry of the same curve, and follow the curved path. We can also use this snapping option for the document's guides. So in this case, inside the Document Studio, I will enable snapping. And under the Guides option, I will tap on Show Guides. Now, I will drag this control handle till it snaps with one of the horizontal or vertical guide. The same applies to the grid positions, spread, margins, and more. The perform construction snapping allows control handle snapping to adjacent nodes and control handles, to reflected angles, to logical triangles, and more. So let us see how that works. In this example, I will drag this control handle and snap it in line to the adjacent node indicated by the purple line. I can also snap it to 90 degrees and reflected angles. I can drag this control handle, then the opposite one, and at a particular point, we will have a perfect logical triangle between the two nodes, again indicated by the purple line. Affinity Designer offers effective ways to transform selected nodes, giving us great precision over placement. So let us go ahead and explore these transformations. The first mode is the transfer mode, which creates a bounding box around selected nodes so we can transform them as a group. So when we select more than one node by adding a one-finger modifier on the canvas, a bounding box appears and we can either rotate those nodes from the rotation handle or tap on one of the transformation points to resize. A one-finger modifier will constrain the movement to 45-degree increments. In conjunction with the transform mode, the enable transform origin will display a movable origin in which the selection box can be rotated. In this case, I will reposition the pivot point to one of the corner nodes so I can rotate the selection box from that point of origin. With the height selection while dragging mode, the selection box is temporarily hidden when transforming. In this case, while rotating or resizing, the selection box remains hidden, and unless it is turned off, this behavior will persist across all objects. The Show Alignment Handles displays alignment handles at the edges and center of the selected object. When we tap on one of these handles, a floating guideline appears across the canvas, so we can drag the handles and position the edges of the selected object in line with this guide. With the selection box from curves, the selection box includes all curves that extend outside the array of currently selected nodes. So when we select a group of nodes, the selection box includes all nodes. But when disabled, the selection will fit the selected nodes, but not the curve. With a cycle selection box, after reshaping, rotating, or shearing an object, this toggles the selection box between a base box and regular bounds. First, we will mark and select all the nodes, with the default mode being the base box, which we can rotate, resize, or what have you. Now, when we tap on the cycle selection box, we switch to the regular bounds, which ignores previous transformations since the bounding box has been reset. Now we can resize and rotate from the new position, which is different from the previous position. We can switch between the base box and the regular bounds and back and forth. Very powerful. Thank you everyone for spending time with me. Let me know if you have any questions below the comments section. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and share the knowledge.